What's up everybody, it's Peter and welcome to our channel. Today is gonna be quite an interesting video. I will do inspection on my Macintosh Plus and we're gonna open it, see how it looks inside. If everything looks fine, we will power it for first time and see in action. Pretty much this Macintosh Plus, it did come in like a carrying case like that, well, carrying bag or so I should call. It's quite big, sorry if it doesn't fit in the camera. On the side has a nice pouch and it has some cables also. Let's see, yeah, that little extension I didn't figure out what for. I mean, that little guy, it's too short. It also come with a couple rubber groomers, I should call. I didn't figure out what for these guys. It's probably holding the cables maybe or so. On the back side, well, on top it has a couple handles. Also on the back side has a handle as well. Actually no, that's the front side, I'm sorry. Yeah, pretty much you can carry it as in vertical position, or you can carry it in a horizontal, which is really nice. Let me open it. And like I mentioned before, it did come with, let's see, yeah, 800K floppy drive. And in really good condition. I mean, as an external. Also, mousepad, it's good. Then, we also will need a mouse if we decided to test it. Let me pull down computer itself. Actually, computer itself, like I'm on my previous video, I did mention it, it's in really, really good condition. And actually, I mean, if you look it closer, well, it has some couple marks of stain or so, some dirt, but otherwise, there's no scratches on the front bezel. There are almost no scratches at all. You know, a rubber fits, looks almost good as new. It's dark color, but it looks really good. The bottom computer looks really nice. No scratches at all, like I said. And discoloration, it's slightly discolorated. If you look at bottom, which never got to a sunlight exposure, and a side, you can tell slightly discoloration. I'm not sure if I was gonna do a retro brightness on this guy, because it's almost in a pristine condition. Probably I'm gonna keep it the way it is. And Macintosh Plus, I believe it's a third generation from that cute, compact style design. It's kind of simple design. 3.5 floppy on the front. Brightness control right there. It's a black and white 9-inch. Keyboard plugs on the back. Let's look at my back. Actually, it's also, I mean, It looks like I said, nice, sleek, simple design. Power switch, power plugged in. Here's the battery compartment. And battery compartment looks really, really almost brand new. Well, it's kind of brand new because it doesn't have any stain, any corrosion, any oxidation. I'm really glad the previous owner, or the owner before previous one, he removed battery in time. He didn't let it corrode it and damage it. Going about ports, pretty much audio. Headphone jack, I should call. DB9 connector for mouse. Then external floppy drive, which we can plug it this guy. SCSI hard drive for her, I mean the SCSI connector for hard drive. Printer and modem. To open it, this unit, you will need Torx T15, and there's a 4 screws. 2 screws here and 2 screws there. Well, let's see. Actually, inside, I'm quite surprised how clean it is. It doesn't look like it has a lot of mileage. I mean, the PCB board, the logic board, It's super clean. That protection paper doesn't have any oxidation or anything. First of all, I have to mention it. I mean, when you open it, monitor, TV monitor, you have to be really careful because there's a high voltage. I mean, this guy was been not powered probably in the last decade or so. Most likely the high voltage has already been discharged long time. But you still have to take precaution and be careful in that area, or discharge it high voltage system. I mean, I forget what it's called. But like I said, you have to be really careful. In our case, I know it's probably been discharged by itself long time ago. I just want to show you how clean that machine looks. It doesn't look like it has a lot of mileage, but also you have to remember it. This machine, I mean, Orly Max, 128, 512 plus, it didn't have any cooling system. I mean, it doesn't have any fan, pretty much. Any other model which do have a fan will bring it dust and will accumulate more dusty, the environment is gonna make, than this guy. Those guys runs, soundless, plus it will not bring it too much dust in and out. Yeah, like I said, it looks really nice. Let me remove it, the shielding. Wow, I'm wondering if ever been removed before. It looks really nice, like I said. But I believe it probably did by previous owner because it did come with some additional memory or so. I'm not sure if that model actually you can even expand. No, actually it is. The Macintosh Plus, it's a 1 megabyte version. I mean, from stock configuration, and also you can upgrade it up to 4 megabyte. But there you have to do some tricks, I believe. You have to remove the resistor or carry the trace or something like that. Anyway, guys, the main board looks like there's only two connectors. I'm gonna hold it like that to make sure you see it. Pretty much ribbon cable for floppy. Let me remove that. And also one more cable for power and video signal. And I believe that's it. And then you just slide it out board. Wow, guys, look at that. It almost looks brand new. Unbelievable how lucky I am to get Macintosh Plus in such a great condition. Unbelievable. I mean, I know previous owner, according to his story, he got this computer from somebody else, from his friend or so, and he never used it. It was sitting in a bag for all that remaining time since he got in his possession. But yeah, it is actually 4 SIM boards, and it's 1 megabyte, 256K each. We can upgrade it easily up to 4 megabyte. But one of those resistors, I'm not sure which one, I have to look at. You have to remove it to be able, system will recognize it for 4 megabytes, which is really cool, will be. I believe it's a 4 megabyte max. Wow, unbelievable. You know what, guys, let's do, what else we should look at? Because like I said, everything else looks really awesome. Let me bring it close and you can see there are almost no particle of dust, a single dust on a logic board. The tube itself is so clean. I'm not see reason. I thought I was gonna pull it out, maybe drive to see how well it is. But I mean, when you look at even drive housing, well, it has slightly little dusty, but there's not much. What about capacitors? Because a lot of time in old equipment, capacitor will be kind of about to explode or start bulging or sign of leakage. And if you look it closer, there's nothing. It's almost as looks nice and clean since they've been left. Actually, on here area, on that area, you see kind of some kind of residue. I'm not really sure if that's from It have to be probably from capacitor, I'm about to say, but it doesn't look like from capacitor. Let's see. Well, let's put it back and we will power it. To put it back, everything goes in a reverse order. Okay guys, let's flip it to power switch and see how lucky we are. Well, at least beeps. That's a good sign right there. Let's see if the monitor is gonna glow. Yep. It's coming back to life. And now it's asking for floppy. To be honest, I don't have too many floppies. So far I got only a few. But let's try it. Macintosh Utility Disk version 6.0.2. That's a good sign right there. Yeah, it does read disks. And like I said, for the last 10 years that Macintosh did spend mostly time in a kitting bag and looks really nice and clean. I was kinda didn't have any doubt it will work, but like I always saying, let's open it and see how good it is, if we can prevent future damage. I mean, why not? Okay, yeah, it does boot. It looks okay. Oh, the mouse cable is quite kind of short. I didn't expect that. Let's see, clean desktop, set startup, restart, shutdown, view. Oh, you know what, let's kind of like click it on the floppy drive and then no, I thought it'll pop more options. Kind of straightforward menu. I got my Performa 575. It looks similar, just black and white. About founder. Let's see. Yeah, not much to see here. System RAM. Yeah, 1 megabyte or so. And alarm clock, calculator, chosen, control panel. Let's see control. I mean, it have to be kind of simple control panel, most likely. I mean, compared to my Performa 575. It is quite simple. There's not much. Pretty much general keyboard, mouse, speakers. I mean, the sound. Let's see mouse. Okay, let's increase it because it kind of slow. Double click, we're gonna leave it the way it is. And since it doesn't have backup battery, as soon as it's gonna power it off, all the settings will kind of reset to factory default. Let's see if the speaker works. Wow, that's nice. And you know what? Let's check contrast. Actually, it is in a full contrast. And that's as low as I can go. The contrast seems to me fine. I mean, that's a full brightness. Man, it looks really nice. I mean, if you look it closer, the kind of picture view, it shifted to the left. Up and down, it's almost all right. It's kind of a little bit high. If you look it up and down. But side to side, you kind of notice it right there. It's slightly to the left. And on those monitors or any CRT monitors, I don't have too much experience how to align it. I should do some research and then we can probably try to align it or just leave it the way it is. The picture itself, since it's a black and white CRT monitor, it looks nice, sharp, clean. I really like it the way it looks. Let's see, general. Actually, here looks like you can change a background. Yeah, actually, you can even create your own. Yep, you can create your own background. That's nice. Time, you can adjust it. Hours. date. I mean, it's, oh, RAM cache. Okay. On and off, you can activate, deactivate, and change its size. And size max, it's a 384. I mean, yeah, 384. Well, it's kind of straightforward. And you see, actually, the volume knob, it's also here. You can adjust it up and down. Well, it's like I said, I'm glad it's up and running. And now I kind of is going to start going through and, well, kind of dig it in a little bit more. See if I can obtain more floppies with some games or so. It's going to be really fun to edit this Mac to my collection, especially in a good running condition. Let's shut it down. Oh, that's nice. Actually, it will bring you, it will inject a floppy. Same as my Macintosh Performer 575. Well, guys, pretty much that's all I got for this video. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you do, thumbs up. If you don't want to miss any future videos, subscribe. We will really appreciate it. Thank you.